right? So how to first read this? How to read? Just you have to read the sentence wherever you are getting exception, right? Exception in thread main. Remember this exception also. You have to explain in interviews what are the exceptions you got in during your automation. So you can tell this. Session not created exception. Could not start a new session. Response code is 500. Message process unexpectedly closed with status. With the status zero. And then read below. Host info, host Ramesh, this is the IP address. And so it will give a suggestion to us also. Driver info. So Firefox driver is not able to start it. That, so when the Firefox is not able to start, such cases you will get a session not created exception. Then how to solve this? So to solve this, you need to see the initialization. Firefox driver initialization is failing. Start session is failing, right? So in order to solve this issue, you need to simply give the Firefox installation location. That binary you need to set it. So how to set this binary? So remember this exception. Please note down this exception, okay? Please note down this exception. I'm pinging you in the chat. Keep it in one place so that in one notepad you keep it saying that WebDriver exceptions. There you put, this is the problem. How you will solve it? I'm giving solution. So the solution, note down that. So the learner, you should do that. Okay, I'm giving a solution for that. See, we are not getting in the Fire Chrome browser, but we are, when you are working with a Firefox, you're getting that issue. Then how to solve it? So you need to set the browser, Firefox browser path, where it is installed, then it will work. But how to set that? So first you have to create object for Firefox options class. Create, because in this class you have a set binary method. So set binary, and I'll give my Firefox installation path. Create object for Firefox options class. Okay, so let's create object Firefox options OPT equal to new Firefox options. See, we will get automatically Firefox options. Then, so this set binary path, set Firefox binary path. So how to set? OPT dot set binary. You see that? Set binary, and you have a string path is there. You can give a string path. See, set binary is overloaded. Set binary is overloaded. So I'm giving this one. So just pass this value. So where is the installation? You can just go to the Firefox, right click, and show more properties. See, this is the installation path. Copy this. That path you give it. So yeah, all this is the done. What is missing? Yeah. So this is a Firefox installation location you need to pass. And then you give this option object reference to Firefox driver. This is the solution. Okay, these three lines of code you need to put there. So I'm giving these three lines of code for you, the solution for that problem. So I'm giving a problem also and the solution both. So you make a note in the notepad. So save this WebDriver exceptions. Okay, clear? So right click and run as Java application. Hey, your browser is launched now perfectly. So that's what you need to get problems. Then automatically you'll get the solutions. Okay. Done. See, all this is the value and you got this value in the long format. See, passed successfully. Even you can run in any browser, but I have just shown you. So Firefox browser. Any questions? And same exercise for you. This you write, and also one more exercise is there. This program you write, and same this program also you write it. Okay. So this program also you write it with Yahoo. We open the Yahoo, and Yahoo also perform the same actions. Search Selenium. So this one. So yahoo.com. You open the yahoo.com. Then search Selenium. Click on torch icon. Then you get the Selenium. So then you select the Selenium. And it will go to. But here it is opening in the next tab. So you have to switch to that tab. So that you have to, but I'll tell that how to do that. But so you try till search results and get this search results. And till that you do that. That's enough. You don't need to click on that. Even in our Selenium also, we are not telling that. Just fetch the search results. I'm not asking to click on that. You fetch the search results. So practice. This is the scenario you practice it. Okay. Any questions? Now we'll go to next scenario 4. So how to select a drop down option from the any website. You take any website, not a problem. And this is scenario 5 is exercise 2. Scenario 4 I'll show you. Scenario 5 is exercise 2. Okay. Using select class, you can do with scenario 4, you can do. Scenario 5 also you can do with, now yesterday I have shown you, right, how to select an option from dropdown using so default process without select class. Now I'll show you in the select class using Amazon, okay? You can put anything, Amazon.com or whatever, it doesn't matter. So I'll do scenario 6. You do 2, 3, 4, 5 scenarios. All 4 scenarios you write automation code. Otherwise, you can write, you know, this select city. So you can perform here itself in the scenario 4 itself. Okay. If you want more thing. Okay. So let's do this using select class, Amazon.com. So you just go to Amazon.com. Okay. So this is the one I was talking. This is the drop down. Okay, so this is the drop down. I need to select these drop down options. How can you select? So let's go and do that select class demo. Select a demo. Take main method, and I'm not going to write again everything again. Already I have taken, I'll just copy paste. So whatever I required. So I want this, I'll use this little bit. So whatever I need, so I'm going to use that. So this code I'm going to reuse. But I'll change my URL. So let's change the URL. So So what is the URL? You can copy from here and you can give it amazon.com. So title, everything I'll get, and I'm going to verify that page title also. Now first, I'm directly coming to drop down. So this one, this drop down. So let's identify this drop down. See, select a tag. So there is a class is there. ID also there. I'll take ID. Okay. We have already practiced it. So with an ID, name, CSS selector, XPath, link text, I have already used them, all the locators. I have covered the locators. I have covered the methods. Now I'm going to cover one more time locators. So just take this and just ID and just going to write that. But here, I'm just identifying the element, okay? So how to identify the element? Web element. So category dropdown equal to, well, just identify. So you take the web element, import it. I don't want this. So next, identify the category dropdown. Write the proper steps so that it will be very easy to understand. If you are not writing the steps, it's difficult. Next, create object. Now I'm started using. So select class. Object for select class. So select cell equal to new select. I need to pass that. Cat DRP object as an argument for my select class constructor. So that's the select class. So select class is ready. Now, so here you can use select class object. Then what is the first step? You want to play around with it. So select an option. Select an option from dropdown. Select an option from dropdown. So that is so option. So these are all things you can, anyone you can select. So this is based on the, I'll select based on the, right? Maybe I'll select beauty and personal care. I'll select this. So this is the label text. So based on the label text, I'm selecting. So I'll go cell dot select by visible text. And give the text. This is the based on the visible text I am selecting. Okay. So, okay, you selected. How do you know if this is selected? How to get the selected options? So, how can you fetch the selected option from drop down? How can you fetch selected option from drop down? So you have to, so I want to text selected option text I want. So which option is selected, that option text I want. How can you get that? So there is a method, get first selected option method you need to use. On top of that, you need to use get text method. Then you will get a string value. String selected visible text, visible option text. I'll write very clearly visible option text equal to. So cell dot get first selected option dot, because this will give you a web element. Get first selected option will give you a web element. Then get text method will give you text of that element. That I'm scrolling here. So this will give web element, dot get text method. So print this. First selected option, visible text option. Said visible text option is the meaningful message I'm putting. Then I can put selected visible text, the variable name I'm printing basically. So this is the first two methods of select class I used already. If you have any doubt, let me know. Red dot sleep. So I'm giving a lot of work for you. And this also you need to do. Almost 5 scenarios you need to automate in 2 days. 5-6 scenarios you need to automate. So that's what I want from you guys. Everybody practice till select class, everything. Now, select an option by value attribute. How can you select an option by value attribute? So cell dot select by value and you give the value. So what is the value? Which value you want to select? So this is the value attribute. You can see here, I'm going to give this one, value attribute. So this one I'm going to select. So copy that. See, value attribute value I'm giving. I'm not giving this one. That's I'm not giving a label text. I'm giving value attribute value. Now again, same procedure, you do that. How can you get that selected option? So because selected value attribute text. So attribute text. So again, method is not going to change. So the variable. First selected value attribute, option is this one. I'm going to use this thread.sleep. See that this is another thing. Then select an option by index. Select an option by index. So now, so what is the method? Cell dot select by index. So I'll give one. One means what is the one from here? Top. So this is the zero, all departments. So what is the second one? Alexa skills will select. Alexa skills will select. So get that. So value. Alexa skills will select now. So this is the 3 ways I'm showing how to select an option. Select value, select option with index. Select option index text. So selected option index text. First selected option with index. With value attribute. Okay, so this is all the 3 ways you can select and you're getting the text also selected one. Now I want to fetch. I'll take another 5 minutes to close this. I'll take all the drop-down options into collection. Fetch all the drop-down options into list. How can you do that? List web element. So opts list equal to cell dot get options method. So this is the I got all the list. So now this list, what you can do is you select last option. How can you select the last option from using this list? See how to do that. That's another scenario. So this is the interview question. How can you select the last option from the dropdown? So these are all the steps you need to perform. You need to get collection. Then you have to use index method. Select last option from dropdown. How can you get the last element index?
Size minus ones.
The collection dot size minus one, which will give you last element index. This is the simple, these two lines of code you need to tell answer for that. Okay, that is also done. Now I'll iterate all the options. Iterate all the options and print drop down values. So I'm going to print all of them. So how can you do that? For loop you can use, for each loop. So web element is the data type of my collection. So opt colon opts ts list, opts list collection name. Maybe did I use somewhere? Duplicate local variable. Somewhere I used. So I can give option. Okay, another name I am giving. So you should not use duplicate local variables. Maybe somewhere I used it. So I'm printing each option text. So option. Okay, Firefox options I used, that there I used. So option dot get text. Each option text I am printing. That's it. So we have used here select class methods, how to select in different ways, and how to get all of them, and how to iterate. So that's what I used. Now, let me put the some difference here. Some wait time here, and I can close the browser. Driver dot close. Okay, so let's run this program. So next class, I'll show you how to select a random option. We are giving values here, right? Instead of giving values, we can select randomly. How can you do that? Oops. So this is some permissions, TYMC. Oh, cut. ALU, continue shopping, okay. So, that time itself it failed. Yeah, it failed. See, Selenium doesn't wait this much time. See, no such element exception. See, this is the one. Why we got a no such element? How to debug this? So where it is looking for a no such element exception, see that. So this also make a note. This also make a note. This entire, see how to debug this? So this is the issue. How to debug this? Make a note, all these, you know, exceptions. But how to debug this? You go from last. See, our package name, class name, method name, line number. See, line number 51. See, you got this. So this is the one, because the page is not loaded. That's why it is not able to find this element. That's why no such element exception you got. So see, unable to locate. Here also you are getting unable to locate element. See, you got the locator. See that ID value. Here also by seeing that this line, reading this line, you will get a very, very clear indication. And still you are not getting, and go and stack trace, complete stack trace. You go step by step to get more clarity. Okay. So now that is the main issue, but let me see Amazon.in. I think you won't get that option, that problem. HTTPS. We should not get that. Yeah, again you got it. XTUTYE. Okay. We got it. By that time it might got the issue. Yes, immediately. Element not interactable exception. See, we got another issue. So this also make a note. See, three exceptions. So these are all the exceptions you are getting. So which element? Please make a note, all these exceptions, these are interview questions. Element option could not be scrolled into view. Because that's not available, that's why it is doing that. Get first selected option, get, okay. I'll use Selenium.in. I'll use this. Then you won't get a problem. Then what is there? Okay, now it's going, okay. No such element exception. Cannot locate option with the text beauty and personal care. Okay, so Indian website and US website, it's different. That is the reason. So this option is not there. That's why no such element exception you're getting. See how to do that? Debug. See line number 56. And that is the problem. Yeah, this is not there. This option is not there. What is the option we have? Let me take so what beauty is there. So that is not there. So I'll just give beauty. So beauty is there. And here also, so let's see other values, what we have, financial, right? Otherwise I can select this one. Anything is fine. This one. I think remaining things will work. Let's move on. Run as Java application. This time it will go fine. Still more issues. Element not interactable exception. I scroll into view. Why we are getting this? Select my visible text. 56. So the drop down locator is saying ID value. What is the ID value? Same. The same only. Then we should not get a problem, right? Let's run this again. Yes, we got another same issue. Element not interactable exception. So let's do with the Chrome browser, okay? So I'll just take this Chrome. See that. Let's see. So one browser we are not able to launch. See, now it's working in the Chrome browser, but failing in the Firefox browser. These are the kind of challenges, right? These are the kind of challenges we need to see why that is failing in the, why it's not able to identify that. See, we are very able to get this data properly, Chrome browser. But so we'll see that. Chrome, Firefox browser, why it's not working in the next class. I'll show you that, okay? So the exercises for you is, all these are the exercises. Till six, you need to write it from 2 to 6. You have to write all the scenarios and practice, okay? Any questions, concerns?
You know, sir.
Oh, so thank you.